Hello guys, welcome to the channel. I hope you all are fine and doing great. Today we are going to discuss this maximum winning score problem of the GFG. So let's move on to the problem. So in this problem, we are given a binary tree. We are given a binary tree. Okay, and whose each node has a value between 1 and 10. Okay, so each node has a positive value greater than 0. So and if we have to find out the maximum product of a value, if we start traverse a tree from root node to all the leaf nodes, okay, then what can be the maximum product of a edge from root? Like suppose this is a tree, and okay, then these are some edges, okay, then we have to return, and you know each node contain value 1 to 10, so our product always increase. Like here, if our product is C, then the minimum value here can be equal to 1, so our product remains C. But if it has value anything other than 1, then the next minimum is 2, so our next value is to C into or we can say 2C. Okay, so our value in next iteration, we can say our value will always increase or remain same. Okay, so here we have to find out, so we will traverse from root node to the leaf node to find out the maximum value, to find out the maximum value of a par. Okay, as we have to multiply each of these, so in each traverse to the next level node or our children node, our value remains same or will increase, and we have to find out the maximum product we can get. So how we will do it, here you can see we will take 4, 8 and 4 path, sum is 128, you can see 4, 8, 4 path, and this is here what we do, we will take an 10 into 5 into 1 is equal to 50, while 10 into 7 is equal to 70, so we have to take on the maximum product part, whether it is a shortest or longest doesn't matter. So how we will do it, so we call a function solve root comma 1. Now root is our current node, 1 is our current multiply sum. What can be the minimum sum here? Can be 1. Okay, as our number of nodes should be between 1 to 1000, and so if we have only one node, then its minimum data can be equal to 1, so our minimum product can be is equal to 1. Okay, so here we will return long node, R is our current node root and C is our current sum. So what we are doing, if our R is equal to null, means we are on the children of leaf node, because you know all the children of our leaf node is equal to null, like these are children, then this is a null node. Okay, this is a null node. Okay, then we will just return C. That means maximum product can be possible with this path is equal to C. Else while if we are at a node, like we are at this and we are got C, our C call this. Okay, I am just changing, like here I am changing the, suppose this is a tree, suppose for a minute this is a tree. Okay, suppose this is a tree, this contain 2, this contain 4, this contain 1, this contain 7, this contain 9, sorry, this contain, suppose this is contain 4, no, 9, and this contain 6, 2, suppose this contain 2. So here our solve 2 comma 1 will call out. Okay, here our C will upgrade, R is not is equal to null, so our C will upgrade to C into R dot R data, so our C will become 2. Okay, now we will call it with solve. We will return maximum of left or right. Okay, solve R left and C. Solve, what is R left? R left is equal to 4. And what is C? C became 2 here. You can see C became 2. And I just want to copy it. Control C. Control V. Okay, yes, let's copy. Okay, so same we will call out, but here what is the difference? Our path is equal to our root left is equal to 9. Okay, then it is how it is equal to null. So it multiplied 2 with 4, so our product will go to 8, and here we will both of these just we will call a function to 4 1 left of 4 and see updated c is equal to 8. Okay, and here like this is solved. Okay, I am not copy pasting or erasing again and again. So here 4 right is equal to 7 and updated c is 8. Okay, and here call will go, it as you know our r is equal to null now, so it will just return c. It will return 8. It will multiply 8 with 1 and our 8 remains 8, so it will return 8. But here 8 is multiplied with 7, 8 7 is 56. 8 7 is 56. It will call out solve null comma 56. Okay, this call is made in this side. Okay, so it will return both of side, actually call will make out the same call will also be make out here. Okay, so it will return 56. Okay, the value of this c, and here we will return 56. Here we will return 56. So from here what we are returning, the maximum of left and right, here 56 56, so it will return 56. It will return 56. Similarly here call will go on right side, call will go on right side with returning 8. Here it will return 8. Okay, it will here from this side, from left side it is 8, from right side it is 56, so it will return 56 the maximum. Okay, the maximum, or it will return 56 the maximum of r left and r right, same. Okay, now the call will go here. Call will go here. Here it is null. So solve 9 comma 2. Okay, so 2 will update it. 2 will update it to 2 into 9, which is 18. It is null. Okay, it is null. Call will go. It will just return 18. It will return from left side of 9. We return 18. We go here with function solve 2 comma 18. Multiply with 2 and became 36. Call go here with the solve null comma 36. Same call will go on left side as well. Both will return 36. Okay, the value of c, it will return 36. So from left side we got 36. From right side we got 36. So 2 will return. 2 will return 36. 2 will return 36. Okay. From left side we got 18. From right side we got 36. So we will return 36. Now from left side we got 56. From right side we got 36. So we will return 56. As our answer. So here for this case we can dry run out 249. We will dry run out 249 249 one seven 49 one and seven seven null and two null and two. Okay, so we have to write null or not. Yes, null and two. So answer should be is equal to 50. Answer should be 56. Yes, you can see answer should be 56. And what is our answer? Our answer is also 36. Okay, so I am running this for the given test cases in my problem solution. 128 given answer. Now I am submitting it. So guys, you can see all the 211 test cases pass out in O n time, n is the number of nodes. So I explain you what we are doing in each step. In each step we are multiplying this value and call the function in next level. When we are at leaf node, child of leaf node means at null node, we will return C. Okay, C, one C from this side, one C from this side. Now maximum of both C. Now one from this side, one from this side, maximum of both. Like similarly, at the end we will got the maximum answer and we will return it. We will return it and we are returning it here as well. Okay. So guys, I hope you all like it. Okay, so guys, I hope you all like it. I explained the solution, and if you still have any doubt, then just comment out. I will try my best to explain you, to clear your doubt. And in the meanwhile, you can like the video, subscribe the channel, and check out my channel for more these type of videos. Now for till next video, thank you for watching this.